guys, it's Quality Gardener back with another video. In today's video, it's about dragon fruit. And this, what I have right here, is dragon fruit. As you can see, this right here is, there's three different varieties of dragon fruit. There is a white flush variety. There is another variety just like this, but it has a red flush variety. And then you have the yellow skin looking variety one. And then also what I have right here is an actual dragon fruit cactus that I've been growing for not too long, probably about a month or two. But this was cut off of another dragon fruit, that our previous dragon fruit plant that I've been growing. And I just put it in some pot mix, and it was originally just this whole thing right here, but since then it's grew this. So pretty exciting. But today I am going to cut open one of these dragon fruits, probably this one. I kind of want to save this one for later because this one I like a lot. So I just want to enjoy eating this one. But this one right here will be the white flush variety one that I will cut open. And if you, I want y'all to pay attention to when I cut it open, to what that, what it looks like inside, the seeds and everything, because it's quite unique. It's just like a, people like to compare it to kiwi, and I do like to say it is similar to kiwi, but I don't think it is as good as kiwi. It does have a unique flavor to it, don't get me wrong, but it's more of a bland version of kiwi, if I have to say for myself. But that's just me. It is very refreshing though. It is very refreshing. If you ever need, you know, if, I don't know if you have tried this or not, but if you have the red flush variety, you can make smoothies and all sorts of good stuff that are really healthy for you, which that's all about. That's what gardening's all about, is about growing stuff and making healthier choices in your diet. So in this next clip, I will be cutting it and I will show you what it looks like. See you. Okay, you guys, I'm back and I cut open this dragon fruit with my knife. And look, this is what I was talking about. Look at the seeds. They look just, they're small, just similar to kiwi seeds. Now I am going to try this for you guys, and because I haven't had this in a while, so I will give it another taste test. I don't know. I just really haven't had a, I mean, I really didn't care for it too much to begin with. But like, it is refreshing, like I was saying, if you ever need something like that. But let me cut off a piece real quick. Hold on, let me get my knife. Sorry, it's hard to hold. I'm holding my phone right now. It's hard to get this piece of dragon fruit out. That should be a good enough piece. Mm-hmm. Now that, now this one has actually been a lot better than the previous ones I've had. It's a lot sweeter. And as I've shown you in the previous clip, the different varieties, and this one, the yellow one I was showing you, is a lot sweeter than the red flush and the white flush variety, like this one. Now, what I plan on doing is I'll probably eat about this half of the dragon fruit, and then I'll save this half and use this to grow new dragon fruit. I probably am gonna give a couple dragon fruit plants away to whoever may want them. So if you want a dragon fruit cactus, let me know, and I might just give you one if I get it growing. I do grow them inside my house during the winter months, so that's what I'll have to do, just like this one. Or the first one I started growing was during, it was during, it was still a little bit cold. It was just now getting to spring, I believe. So it was like early April, started really growing into June. That's when it really started hitting off, because during those June or April and May, it was raining those 2 months, and it didn't get much sunlight, so it had a harder time growing. But I'm going to tell you some interesting things about dragon fruit and the plant itself. The plant itself is not hard to grow at all. I don't know if you've ever grown one or not, but for me, when I first started growing these, it didn't take long for it to sprout the seeds. It took about, let's see, a week, I guess. Which normally it could take anywhere from a week to 3 weeks, depending on the variety, maybe. I don't know too much about that. But the point is, it didn't take me that long to grow it. So if you want to grow one, it shouldn't take you that long. And it's really interesting how these things grow, because I don't know if you've ever seen any pictures about these things, or like seen any online pictures or any videos or anything like that on YouTube or on Google or whatever. But if you notice, when they're fully grown, they're called a dragon fruit tree in a way, because they grow up these pillars. And they fall, like, you know, they fall over. And they're almost, they look just like a tree. But they like to climb. As you can see, this guy, little guy over here, he's branching off to the top. And this is him, showing me that, you know, it's ready to start climbing up something. I do, inside my house, I have it climbing up against the wall as of right now, till I can find something. I can tie it around with and let it climb up that instead. But right now it's just up on my wall right now. But you know, these things aren't hard. Like, when it comes to water management, I water it probably once every 2-3 weeks, maybe, at the most. So I mean, you don't have to water them too much, but you do have to water them more than you would a normal cactus, because these are not normal cactuses. These are considered tropical cactuses because of their geographical location. They originated in Asia. But you make sure you do water them. And personally, I've heard people saying to germinate the dragon fruit seeds, not to go off topic or anything, but when it comes to germinating the seeds, they say to, or with any seeds in period, to have these seeds and put them in a little solution of hydrogen peroxide. But I've tried that. I've tried that with a lot of the dragon fruits. I tried that with the avocado tree I was growing or trying to grow. I had two avocado trees. One's doing good, which I will show y'all in another video. But one was, it started growing, it had the roots and everything, the root system and everything, but then it developed like some type of fungus or rot, root rot, and it died on me, which is sad to say, but it happens sometimes. But I personally would not put hydrogen peroxide on your seeds. That's just me, though. There might be a specific amount or solution to help germinate it, but from my personal use of hydrogen peroxide on seeds, it never turned out too well. But that's just my personal opinion. You can take it or leave it, it's up to you. But I'm gonna get another piece real quick, because that's really actually good. But, like I was saying, you know, if you try planning on growing these things, they're not hard to grow. They're very cool to grow, especially if you have kids who are just now getting into the, gardening, you know, or they're getting into gardening. It'd be a fun experience for you as parents or kids or whoever to, try this out with each other. Gardening itself is just a wonderful experience because you get to watch the effort that you put into something, you know, have an output. You know, you have, you know, if you grow tomatoes or a tomato plant, you know, all that effort you put into that tomato plant, at the end of the season, you're gonna be able to harvest what the effort that you put into that, you know, tomato plant, and you get to eat it, and you know, it's part of a healthy living style, which I enjoy very much. I've been growing stuff for a long time now, probably for about 4 or 5 years, but I figured I'd start making videos for you guys, showing you different types of plants and my plant specifically, and hopefully to encourage you guys to start growing your own stuff or have your own garden. But that's all I have for you guys today. I just wanted to share a little bit about the dragon fruit, show y'all what it looks like inside. I'm gonna eat this after I get done with the video, and maybe if y'all are encouraged to grow anything because of this video, let me know. That would mean a lot to me. But that's all I have for you guys today. Thank y'all for watching. Please like and subscribe. And I'll see y'all next time. Bye.